In dem Video erkläre ich euch ein bisschen was.
This video is about our drive on scissor lifts. There are two. The TWS A40 as we have it here, and the TWS A42U. Now, a short explanation of the name. SA stands for drive on scissor lift. As mentioned, we have the 40 here, which means it has a maximum lifting capacity of 4 tons. The SA42U has a lifting capacity of 4.2 tons and is also installed under floor like our S318U, that is designed to be installed under the floor. Here we have a lift that is ideal. For example, for an inspection center, for wheel alignment, or even for headlight adjustment as well. But it's also ideal as a service lift, because the client can drive on the lift, and then the vehicle can be inspected directly. The SA40 has a maximum lifting height of 1.8 meters. The maximum lifting height is 2.04 meters for the SA42U. Besides that, we have the integrated wheel-free jack, which also has extendable platforms as the TWS 318U for longer vehicles. For example, to be able to reach optimally under the desired vehicle. The lift is also equipped with these plates as standard. They can be displaced in order for me to place an optional turn plate under the wheel when performing a wheel alignment. The turn plates can be acquired separately. Then I can arrange these plates to place my turn plate exactly where it needs to be. In addition, both lifts have this sliding plates as standard. They are important for achieving the necessary tension reduction on the wheels during the alignment. Both of these scissor lifts also have a pneumatic safety release, just as our double scissor lifts. Which means this carriage is lifted by the push of a button and the lift can be lowered. And now a few words about the control unit of the drive-on scissor lifts. Here we have an up button, a down one and a down two button. This has the following reason. With down one, the lift is lowered to a height of 60 centimeters so that you can make sure once again whether the track of the lift is free, whether there are still any tools or other things under the lift which could damage the lift or the people around it. Down 2 can be used when you're sure that everything is okay and you can lower the lift without any problems. Then down 2 can be pressed and the lift is lowered all the way down. Of course, with the lock button the lift can be lowered onto the next safety catch. Up here we have a small switch to shift from main to jack, that is from the platform to the separate wheel-free jack. If I switch here, then I can raise or lower the wheel-free jack. Of course, the wheel-free jack also has safety catches so that the vehicle cannot descend unexpectedly for any reason and nothing can happen. Both drive-on scissor lifts are available with a drive voltage of 400 volts. Of course, we have this roll-off protection on both lifts, which is designed to protect the vehicle from falling if it starts rolling unexpectedly or something, so that it cannot fall forwards. The SA42U has this plates both on the front and the rear because it logically doesn't need any access ramps. The SA40 has these separate access ramps here on the rear. Logically they are there primarily to drive onto the lift, so that there's no tall barrier to overcome. So, I can drive easily onto the lift even with low vehicles like a Porsche 911 or something similar, because the approach angle is kept very low by the long access ramps. Now we are under the lift. There's nothing spectacular to see here. That's not the case for the SA42U. It's delivered with LED strips that are completely distributed along the platforms. I can turn them on and off according to my needs, depending on my lighting conditions. Besides that, the SA42U also has tracks for the optional axle jack, which I can acquire with the lift. It has the advantage of allowing me to lift vehicles axially, which is particularly helpful for long vans that can no longer be lifted with the wheel-free jack. I hope I could help you a bit further with this video. You now have the option of choosing a suitable lift below if you have already decided on a specific model. Among other things, you'll find individual product videos and assembly videos for each lift. If you still have any questions or doubts, then you can always give us a call. Either I or one of my colleagues will help you further with any specific questions. Otherwise, thanks for watching.